Hello, I'm Dr. Maria Gosai. I'm a consultant radiologist, and I'd like to show you this prostate MRI case. We have a 65-year-old man with an elevated PSA level of 7.9, which was detected on screening. His digital rectal examination was normal, and he's never had a prostate biopsy before. So here we have axial images at the mid-gland level from a multiparametric MRI of the prostate. Now this is a good way to view those images by linking the axial T2 weighted, high B value diffusion weighted, and apparent diffusion coefficient or ADC map in adjacent windows. And we can see here circled on the T2 weighted image a non-circumscribed hypo-intense lesion involving the anterior transition zone, and this measured 1.8 centimeters maximally. Now looking at the high B value DWI, we see that this lesion is hyper-intense, and on the ADC map, there's corresponding marked hypo-intense signal. And so this high signal on the high B value DWI with corresponding low signal on the ADC map is indicative of restricted diffusion. And here I'm showing you the same T2 weighted image, but now alongside is a corresponding image from the dynamic contrast enhancement series. And within the circle, you see focal early enhancement corresponding with the T2 weighted abnormality. These MRI features are consistent with a PIRADS 5 lesion, meaning that clinically significant cancer is highly likely. So let's recall, this lesion was moderately hypo-intense on T2 weighted imaging with ill-defined margins. It showed restricted diffusion as evidenced by marked hyper-intensity on high B-value DWI and hypo-intensity on ADC, and showed focal early enhancement. So some differentials to consider. Benign stromal nodules can show restricted diffusion, but these should be spherical in shape with well-defined margins. Sometimes a thickened anterior fibromuscular stroma can mimic an anterior transition zone tumor, but this normal variant should not show focal high signal on high B-value DWI and should be relatively hypovascular. Lastly, granulomatous prostatitis can mimic prostate cancer clinically and radiologically. A large portion of non-enhancement within the lesion can suggest this diagnosis, but biopsy is often necessary to differentiate from clinically significant prostate cancer. So for the transition zone, remember that T2 weighted imaging is your primary determining sequence. A PIRADS 4 or 5 lesion is defined as lenticular or non-circumscribed, homogeneous and moderately hypo-intense. And when a lesion like this is 1.5 centimeters or larger, or shows definite extraprostatic extension or invasive behavior, then it belongs in the PIRADS 5 category. And both the dynamic contrast and DWI sequences can help draw your attention to pathology that you can then further define on T2 weighted images. And these sequences are also helpful in differentiating true tumors from pathology mimics. I'd like to encourage you to check out the full case on the RSNA Case Collection website for further information on prognosis and treatment. Thank you very much for listening.